and the Lord of Lords. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Master Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you. We know that you are love. We love you. We love you. Everything we have is from Jesus. God bless you. Good afternoon. Whether you're watching me from here, it's afternoon. Good morning. If you're watching me from here, it's morning. Good evening. If it's evening. Whatever the time, this is your friend, your brother. I'm not your enemy. Paul Adler, formerly Muhammad Adler. We're celebrating what we call Pentecost. That'll be tomorrow. I also have the Global Outreach Day. So after going out and coming here, I also want to just inspire you. You see, friend, beloved, life is like a football match. That's the way life is. It's like playing the final of the Champions League or the World Cup or the African Cup of Nations or the whatever you name it, you call it. Life is like the finals of a football match. At the end of it all, there must be a winner. And there is a referee. The final whistle will be blown. And since there is a winner, there must also be a loser, because it's like a football match. So there are winners and there are losers. And there is a referee in life. That referee is God, who sent his son Jesus for us. And you and I are the players in this match. You know, at the end of it all, at the end of it all, the final whistle will be blown. That final whistle can be when Jesus comes suddenly. We call it, as Christians, the rapture, when the trumpet is blown and Jesus just appears suddenly. That final whistle can be when you die. When you die. Amazingly. The Bible says it. It's appointed for a man to die once and after that the judgment. So that final whistle can be when you die. You're not going to die now. God will satisfy us with long life. But friend, have you made up your mind in this game, in this football match? On which side will you be? Will you be on the winning side or on the losing side? Because definitely, the whistle will want to be blown. So on whose side will you be? The winning side or the losing side? About 14 years ago or more, in some months, I took a look, a review, an overhaul of my life. I started praying strangely from a Muslim background. 5 daily prayer Muslim, born by a father who is also a 5 daily prayer Muslim. But I became dissatisfied with some aspect of my life. So I started to pray to Allah, because Allah that I knew. I prayed that I want peace. I want my life to be okay. My home, marriage, everything to be settled. I want things to work for me. I want peace. I want joy. Then, June 2005, I went to a friend's place who is a born-again Christian. And he gave me a CD, a disc, about 5 of it. Because when I went to his house, he was playing Christian music. So I was so amazed with this Christian music he was playing. And I loved them. So I said, oh no, I'll burn them for you. I'll give them to you. So he gave me. And I noticed that I put those CDs in the car. It was a 5 CD changer car. I put the CDs. I did not remove those CDs until I got saved on the 30th of October 2005. I didn't remove them. Now, that was June, October 1st. I was fasting. I got about 2-3 days to the end of Ramadan. And miraculously, I found myself in a church, one of the parishes of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. It's called the Fountain. And the gentleman or elder or father in the faith who has gone to be in the Lord that came was also a Muslim. He came from Nigeria. And he has already said to his family members that God sent him for one man. He came for one man. Remember, I didn't know. I have no idea about this. God was planning how he was going to snatch me from the hand of the enemy. You'll find out why I say the hand of the enemy. So that day, he himself got saved from Islam. He preached a simple sermon. And John 14, 1 to 3 came up. And that's the same Bible verse that I've learned because I went to a Christian primary school. A Christian primary school, though I was a Muslim. But I've learned that John 14, when I was in primary school, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. In my father's house, there are many mansions. If you are not so, I will have told you, I will go and prepare a place for you and I will come again and I will take you to myself. And where I am, there you'll be also. I've learned it by heart from primary school. But suddenly, before I got saved, that those verses of the Bible were just coming up. So he's quoted those verses and asked who wants to come to faith. Otherwise, we call it the altar call. And I went forward to become a Christian from a fervent Muslim background. The devil straight away started speaking. You will lose this, you will lose that, you will lose. I had this fear first that came. But instantly, as those voices were speaking, something came up. A peace I cannot explain. So when people ask me, they say, tell us, be sincere. What are your experiences as a Muslim? Because some of these people, they know me. Some of my friends now who were saying, we won't call you Paul, you're Muhammad. I thank God now, they are getting saved. I really thank God, their eyes are opening. And I thank God for it. You know, I thank God. Some of them, they don't call me in the past, but now I'm getting amazing results. God is making things happen. He's answering prayers. You see, what are the things that you can say as a Muslim and as a Christian now? What are the things? The first thing I would say to people, it's peace. It's peace. I didn't have the peace and the joy that I found in Christ when I was a Muslim, 5 daily prayer. Imagine, I was 5 daily prayer Muslim. I fast, but I didn't have the peace and the joy that I had the moment I gave my life to Christ. It was so evident that one day I've gone to the shopping mall to buy some stuff from where I was working. And some couple saw me, and they said, they were talking, now look at this man. He looks so peaceful. We can see peace all over him. They didn't know that they knew me. They saw me in the morning, and I went back in the shopping mall, in the bank, I think, this time, and they saw me in the evening. And they said, we saw you in the morning. And we were discussing that, look at this man. He has peace all over him. And I knew them. And I said to them, yes, I've given my life to Christ. I'm now a Christian. It's no wonder. Evidence of peace that other people can see clearly came. Joy came. Because the Bible says Jesus Christ is glad tidings of great joy that will be to all people. He's the Prince of Peace. You can't get peace outside any man. From any man, rather. You can't get peace from any man except from this man called Jesus Christ. So peace, they came. The peace is so much that it's overflowing. You know, there's this young man that works for one of the banks in the UK. He said to me, he's a Muslim young man, Asian young man. He said to me, he said, anytime you come to this branch, I feel very happy. He said, I feel very joyful. He said, I don't know why. He said, anytime I see you, I just feel joyful, I feel peaceful. He said, I don't know why. In the midst with his colleagues were like, when he was saying this, peace that overflowed to others is the first thing and joy. The second thing which I will end with is deliverance. Deliverance. What do I mean by deliverance? The Bible says, whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. So the day you call upon Jesus, all the forces of darkness that have been holding you, they will let go. Because Jesus says, who the Son make free is free indeed. I used to have terrifying dreams. I mean, dreams I never liked. I share it often. Women coming to sleep with me, snake biting me. These are terrifying dreams, nightmares. I will wake up and begin to do some pack, some stuff, do some straight nightmares. The enemy was really out of my destiny. I mean, terrifying dreams. But you know what, beloved? Friend, the moment I became a Christian, victory came over those dreams. Now, why didn't the victory come? Because some people will ask me, some of my Muslim friends, say, you would have gone to the senior people in Islam, the people that really know it. My father was, so you say he's dead, so I can't go to him. I have friends that know about it. Even me, I was reading the Quran, reading the books of Ahmed Didat, reading other books. Why is it that help did not come? You know what, beloved friend? Because there's only one deliverer. Only one. All the other ones, if they take one stuff, they put a bigger one. They put a bigger one. If you say you have this problem and you go to somebody that is not a real Christian talking about Jesus, if that problem subsides, not that it's removed, subsides, a bigger one comes up later. There's only one man. When he takes away the yoke, he takes it forever, except you go to sin. That's why he says, come unto me, all ye that labor, those that are in trouble, those that are carrying heavy loads. He said, come, I will give you rest. And that's why I was delivered. Because I came to the real, the original. I came to my creator, not the impostor. As I conclude this, you say, perhaps he's making it up. He's making it, just one people who is making it up. I like I say to people on the street, I said, I have no cause to make anything up. I have none. I don't have to make it up. Okay? I have no cause to make it up. You see, the devil is wicked. In the fight for your soul, because he knows that now that you are not in Christ, he has you. He's holding you in his grip tightly. He doesn't want to lose you. But God says his hands are open. He's always knocking at your door. If you decide today and say, enough, it's enough. My eyes are open. Amongst all the books and the historical facts, it's only the Quran and the teachings of Islam that says Jesus Christ did not die on the cross. When there is a clear evidence, his grave is there. Everything about Jesus has historical proof. And we are taught as Muslims that he did not die on the cross. It appeared as if he died. Then somebody is afraid of the death of Christ. And who is that person? The devil. The devil. He knows the death of Christ was what gave you and I victory over him. So he has done everything to hold your mind so that you will not understand that Christ died for you. Friend, I'm closing. Will you make up your mind today? Or anytime you hear this message, to surrender to Jesus as your Lord and Savior? These are simple words I said that day. And the devil lost his power, his grip over my soul. Will you say, Lord Jesus, I confess you as my Lord and Savior. Come into my life. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you made that confession, our numbers are on the screen. Email address, website. Give us a call. Text us. Whatever, get in touch with us. I will begin to lead you to how you will stand your ground. Because when I gave my life to Christ, people were bold enough to tell me that we give you 1 week. We give you 2 weeks. You come back. People are turning away from me. And I know the challenges people face when they come from, whether any of the false faith to Jesus. I know. Because God has trained us over the years. You get in church. I'll begin to put you through. And nobody will ever conquer you, because Jesus will always be with you. Your testimony will be like someone who told me, hey, you will come back. And years back, he was asking me, pray for us using this your Jesus, because Jesus is powerful. God bless you. Have a very good evening. This deal is, message is just to inspire you to stay up and to see you saved this time. God bless you and goodbye. Bye.